this message is getting across for?
Actually, if you look at the attitude of these women, they are so committed and they are so selfless that in this heat, they have come all the way walking in this heat from Hyderabad. And if you compare their attitude and their behavior with that of the successive governments of Pakistan, you find that there is a very big contrast. First of all, you look at the way Musharraf behaved, the way he handed over a Pakistani innocent woman to the United States. And then after that, we've had People's Party government, we've had PMLN government, but none of them have fulfilled their responsibilities. They have not written the letter that a lot of US people have told us that if the government of Pakistan writes this letter, then something can be done for Dr. Aafia. So I would like to take this opportunity to urge upon the government of Pakistan to immediately write this letter, because Dr. Aafia is totally innocent. There are no terrorism charges on her too. And even if there were any terrorism charges, you know, there are so many governments all over the world that come and fight for their citizens, even if they have serious charges against them. But Dr. Aafia doesn't even have any charge, any terrorism charge against her. So I would like to take this opportunity to urge the government of Pakistan to immediately write this letter, which will pave the way for Dr. Aafia's release.
Do you think that they have some extradition treaty? They don't have any extradition treaty with the US.
If we don't have any extradition treaty, how did we leave Raymond Davis? How did we release him? Because we have been releasing US and besides Raymond Davis.
Do you think your Prime Minister particularly and your government is in a position, because they were stripped naked recently on the Canadian John F. Kennedy Airport?
Yeah, but I think that is something else, because if they're very keen on going to the US and they don't mind being stripped, that's another thing. But what we are saying is that they must fulfill their obligations to the people of this country, and particularly to a woman who has been living in isolation. She's been jailed for the last 15 years.
And finally, it's maybe I'm asking the very emotional questions from every heart of Pakistanis, that this minority lady who is also a presidential or maybe international human rights award winner, but she's saying that my award is of no use if I do not voice for a daughter like Aafia. What do you think? Is it the right time? It's now time for other celebrities, particularly Sharmeen Ubaid Chinoy and other people who got the awards from there but kept their mum. What's your message to them?
I think I'm very impressed with Vahili Kolu, because I think that she has shown that she doesn't care about these worldly worldly gifts and these wealth and all this money, and she is so committed that she's prepared to sacrifice a personal whatever has been given to her in return for Dr. Aafia's release. So I'm really very impressed with Vahili Kolu.